This time around, we are playing Until Dawn. I've actually played and finished this game. I do like it. There's been a few people who've been trying to get me to start playing it for the channel. They want to see my choices. So I was like, alright, let's do it. The butterfly effect. A tiny butterfly flapping its wings may lead to a devastating hurricane weeks from now. The smallest decision can dramatically change the future. Your actions will shape how the story unfolds. Your story is one of many possibilities. Another reason I also want to play this, choose your actions carefully, is there's another one coming out. Another game that's just like this, from this, I believe it's from the creator. Yeah, it's from the creators of Until Dawn. Same thing, same mechanic. Your choices affect what happens. And I'm entirely looking forward to it. I can't remember what it's called. Let me see if I can find it.
Oh my god, I can't believe you actually did this.
Don't you guys think this is a little bit wrong?
Come on, she deserves it.
And it's not her fault that she has a huge crush on
Mike. Hannah's been making the moves on him. I'm just looking out for my girl, Em.
Just because he's class prez doesn't mean he belongs to everyone. Mike is my man.
Hey, Em, I'm not anybody's man.
Whatever you say, darling.
Man of Medan. That's what it's called.
Hannah!
Sorry, I was taking a drink. Bump my microphone.
It's Hannah.
Hey, Hannah.
I turn on subtitles.
Hey, did you see that? Dad said it'd just be us this weekend. Josh.
All right. Settings. Subtitles. Yeah, that might be help a little better. All right. Jeremiah Craig.
Jeez, Josh. Once again, brother, you've outdone us all. Oh my God.
Oops.
What did our naive sister get herself into now? I got your note.
Glad you can make it. Maybe we should start with a little, you know, making out and see where it goes from there. Oh, hell yeah.
Hannah.
I'm sorry, Hannah.
Hey,
it's all gonna happen.
Just a stupid prank.
Hey.
You guys are jerks. You know that? Hannah! Josh! Josh! Fuck! Guys, there's someone outside. What the hell? Hannah! What's going on? Where's my sister going?
It's fine. She just can't take a joke.
It was just a prank, Han. What did you do?
We just messed around, Beth. It wasn't serious.
You jerks! Hannah! Hannah!
So, should we go after her?
You know, I kind of think you're the last person she wants to see right now, Mike.
Oh, shit!
Quick time events. Better following the noise. Use the touchpad as shown.
Hannah!
I tried playing this game with a phone, with a controller that doesn't have a freaking working touchpad. Fuck you, dear.
Hello? Hello?
Show me how I will die. Death totem. Now, if you've never actually seen this game, I won't do spoilers this entire time. I won't explain what that is.
What the hell was that? Hannah! Hannah!
Hello?
Hannah! Oh my god, you must be freezing. Here, take my coat.
I'm such an idiot. I'm so dumb.
No! No!
I'm so sorry.
I'm such a dick. I think the first time I played this through... Yeah, the first time I played this through, I didn't drop Hannah. For you guys, I gotta be the dick.
Again, there are a few things I need to make sure you understand. You see, okay. No one can change what happened last year. The past is beyond our control. You have to accept this in order to move forward. But there is freedom in this revelation. Everything you do, every decision you make from now on will open doors to the future. I want you to remember this. I want you to remember this as you play your game. Every single choice will affect your fate and the fate of those around you. So, you have committed to commence with this game. This is significant. And
is
I want
it?
To help you see it through.
Okay.
Sometimes these things can be a little scary. Even terrifying, but I'm here to make sure that no matter how upsetting things may get, you will always find a way to work through it.
Yeah.
All right. We will start with a simple exercise. Could you please pick up a card? And I want you to look at the picture on the other side and tell me what you feel about it. It is essential that you answer honestly in order to get the most out of this experience.
Well, sometimes the most honest answers are the ones that you don't want to hear.
So, how did that picture make you feel?
Picture?
To be honest.
I'll be honest. I kind of like farms.
Oh, that's good. In what way did it make you happy?
Met a farm girl there once.
Oh. Interesting.
He's writing in an area that's already been written.
Would it make you happy to spend the whole week here all by yourself?
Oh, yeah.
Huh. And what if I told you that this cottage was haunted?
That makes it exciting. Honestly, I'd be scared. It.
Oh, what lies beyond the veil of death is, after all, the ultimate unknown.
I would still stay there. I legitimately enjoy getting a good scare every now and then.
Uncertainty. Oh, I'm sorry we're out of time for this session. We'll talk again very soon.
Will we? Or will you do all the talking? Oh, excuse me. I feel like this song is slightly copyrighted, and I'm probably going to get hit with a copyright here. Thank you.
the one-year anniversary of the dreadful tragedy that took place on Mount Washington. Annie Klein was in charge of the investigation.
Thanks for having me, Marty.
Listeners, an update on Hannah and Beth Washington, the twins who are still missing.
1 year ago tonight, the Washington girls left the safety of their parents' lodge and headed out into a snowstorm.
Foul play.
Not officially, no. There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently unknown. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. He had warned them against pursuing their construction project and claimed the land was sacred to his forefathers.
You know, there is still the old sanatorium on the mountain. Could he be hiding there?
My officers did search the grounds, but the girls themselves couldn't have made it that far.
Something about that mountain seems to breed tragic events.
More than you know, Marty.
Well, thank you for joining us, Annie. With all the Washingtons tonight, their son Josh, on this, the anniversary of the mysterious disappearance of Hannah and Beth Washington.
Well, hello, friends and fans. All right, let's do that again. All right. Well, hello, friends and fans. It's beyond awesome to have you guys all back this year. First off, I gotta say, I am super excited to welcome all my pals back to the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway.
Ah! You sound like you're already drunk, dude.
Let me just let you know, let's take a moment to address the elephant in the room for a second.
Why would we dress an elephant?
I know, you're all probably worried about me, and I know it's gonna be tough on all of us going back after what happened last year, but I just want you all to know, it means so much to me that we're doing this, and I know it would mean so much to Hannah and Beth that we're all still here together, and I'm thinking of them. I really want to spend some quality time with each and every one of you, and just share some moments that we'll never forget. For the sake of my sisters, and, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's party like we're fucking porn stars, okay? Make this one trip we will never forget, all right? Yes!
Yeah, that's a great way to honor your sisters, dude. Party like porn stars. Sam, Hannah's best friend, diligent, conservative, and adventurous.
Hello? Someone there?
It sounded like he was doing things to himself in the bushes there. Busted, climb over. Oh. It's on the back of an email. Let's do the safe. Let's see if she can do it. My fat ass wouldn't make it. I fed a squirrel. Well, I'm sure what to do. Press R1, it'll tell you what you need to do. Look at all this stuff. Totem.
Cool.
So yeah. Basically, the tribes believe that these colors of butterflies were special things: death, danger, loss, guidance, and fortune. Okay. Let me pick it up. Guidance totem. Let's close the bag. We'll be nice.
Chris?
Sam, hey, you made it.
Chris has a crush on Ashley. Methodical, protective, humorous.
Oh,
methodical.
So
oh my god, I
can't
talk.
Kinda amazing.
Or read.
What?
I'm not gonna tell you. You gotta see for yourself. Come on, it's this way.
Where?
Right around here. Gonna blow your mind.
Blow my mind.
Oh man, look at this.
Nice.
The mystery.
Think we'll
man.
Get a visit from America's Most Wanted?
Looks like someone thought so.
Oh, come on. This place is abandoned most of the year. We could, ta-da. Pretty rad, right?
Yeah.
Come on. Look at these beauties.
Beauties is not the word that comes to mind. Why is this even here?
What do you mean?
What the hell is a shooting range doing at the base of a ski lodge?
Dude, have you ever met Josh's dad?
Yeah.
He thinks he's like Grizzly Adams or something. Wanna try?
No, you go ahead, Grizzly.
All right, here goes.
All right.
Alright, I'm bad. I'm a badass.
I'm gonna go ahead and guess it was a wild case of beginner's luck.
I don't think so, girl.
Well, anybody and their brother could shoot a bottle that big, that close.
I don't want to shoot the squirrel. I like the squirrel.
Nice shot.
Your ass just got sacked.
Hey, sharpshooter, a ride's coming.
Wait, I'm just getting the hang of this.
Come on, Chris, the cable car.
Butterfly effect update. Status update. Let's see here. Yeah, Sam likes me a little bit more because I didn't shoot the squirrel. It's okay, I like Sam. Okay, so yeah, the butterfly effect.
Man, it is. It's definitely weird coming back up here after a whole year.
Yeah, I swear, the moment I got here, back.
Here goes fast.
Almost. The past is beyond your control.
Hey, that's weird. Door's locked.
Yeah. Josh wanted us to keep it locked. Keep people out.
He said that? What people?
I don't know. He said they found people sleeping in the station one time.
It's creepy. Gentlemen. It must be really hard on Josh.
Yes, really
I
hard.
I don't know how he keeps it all together. That'd be a wreck.
Well, we're all just gonna have to keep an eye on him. He's been going through so much, and he seems like the kind of guy who's not gonna just ask for help, you know?
Hotel and sanatorium.
What a crazy place to set up house. I mean, no matter how rich you are.
They're not so rich. They only bought a mountain.
Huh? I was looking at the bathtub, then switched.
Big mountain.
Yeah. So beautiful in the day, but at night just feels menacing, like a sleeping giant.
You gonna publish?
What?
Your pretty poem. The Sleeping Giant of Blackwood Forest.
Oh, shut up. Finally. You coming?
Yeah, well, I was gonna stay here and catch some Z's, but okay. Just like going to the prom.
Here you go.
Great. Adventure begins.
Oh, I hope this was the right thing to do.
What?
You know, getting everyone together on the anniversary. I mean, Josh
no.
Seemed really pumped about us all doing something, didn't he?
Yeah, no, he definitely did. I haven't seen him so excited about something in forever.
Good, good. It's hard to tell with him, and I'm kind of been worried.
No, it was a good idea.
It's a horrible idea.
Same way.
We're all here, aren't we?
Thanks,
unfortunately.
Bro. Good talk.
You know what? Let's just stop talking about what happened and enjoy the trip.
Yes, let's enjoy the trip.
You know how Josh and I met?
No.
Okay. Third grade. Josh sat in the back of the room. I sat in the front. We didn't even know each other existed. But the kid sitting next to Josh started strap snapping the training bra on the girl in front of him. So the teacher made him move to the front, where I was sitting.
Okay, so?
So I got moved to the back.
And?
And next to Josh. That's how we met. I mean, and became friends to this day.
A match made in heaven.
If it weren't for the fact that Jeannie Simmons hit puberty like 3 years early, and on that day decided to wear a low-cut shirt that showed off her training bra, I mean, who knows? You could be riding in this cable car alone. Right now. Or talking to some other person entirely. Boom. Butterfly effect.
Yeah, let's talk about the butterfly effect here. I've done one bad thing and two good things. I think I've achieved a bit of a balance. Not much of one, though. Jess, Mike's new girlfriend. Confident, trusting, irreverent.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy. New people. Time to meet and greet.
Excuse me.
What the hell?
Jess, hey!
Jessica, over here! Are you guys having a really weird stroke?
We're stuck in this stupid thing.
Can you please let us out? Pretty please?
Push the button.
Oh my god. I thought we were goners. Another 10 minutes in there and I would have chewed off my own leg.
Oh, sick, Chris.
Look, I got a lot of meat on my bones. This is all muscle down here.
Yeah, right. Hey!
Well, what do we have
Chris.
Here? My goodness! Seems that someone has a little crush on our good friend and dear class president Michael Monroe.
Chris.
And what kind of sizzling erotica might our Jessica be capable of imagining? I wonder.
Mike and M split. We're together.
Whoa. Drama.
Not really. Pretty clear cut, actually. M's out, I'm in.
Huh.
All right. Let's just get up to the lodge already. It's getting tired of all this nature and junk.
You guys go ahead. I'm just gonna wait here for a bit. See who else is coming.
You mean Mike?
What? I mean, you know, whoever.
Uh-huh. Sam?
Did you see this view? I mean, holy cow. Sometimes I forget to just stop and take it all in.
Seriously, couldn't they have built the lodge, like, right where the cable car ends?
Emily, Mike's ex. Intelligent, resourceful, persuasive, fucking bitch.
I don't think it would have been, like, as pretty.
Matt, Emily's new boyfriend. Motivated, ambitious, active,
no.
Pretty decent
dude. And where's the bellboy when you need one? Getting chills.
We're almost there.
No, I mean, getting kind of...
My whole goal in this is to try to keep everyone alive.
It's gonna be weird seeing everyone up here again.
Definitely not gonna feel like a regular party. I mean, what do you think? Ah!
Jesus!
And there's Mike, Emily's ex, intelligent, driven, persuasive, kind of a dipshit.
You guys.
Michael!
You really, really should have seen your faces right there. Dude, I almost clocked you just now. Nice one.
Michael, you're a jerk.
Come on. Guys, we're all friends here, right? No need for violence, just a little harmless fun. We're up in the woods, spooky. Come on.
Basically, every time you don't side with Emily, she hates
you
more.
I'm just trying to lighten the mood, Em. Don't be like that.
Like what?
The way you're being. You always get like this. Michael, I'm just gonna lay it out, otherwise this whole weekend's gonna suck ass for everyone. This is super awkward. And
your face is already dirty.
Let's just acknowledge it now and move on, okay?
Matt.
I hear you, man. I get it. I don't wanna make this weird.
Cool. So we're good?
All good.
You guys gonna make out now?
Oh yep. My god, totally. We're so gonna make out.
No. Seriously, I'm gonna go check on the cable car back down the trail.
See you, man.
See ya.
All right.
See ya.
Let's see what our status update happened. Let me guess. Emily hates me a little bit. Yep. Yep.
Hey, could you take these the rest of the way?
The bags?
Yeah, all the bags.
Why?
I need to go find Sam.
Sorry, didn't mean to keep thumping the microphone.
Okay.
Sorry, I really need to go find her. I totally forgot I needed to talk to her before we get all the way up there.
This really can't wait. We're almost there.
It's important, Matt, please.
All right, fine. It's so important, I guess I can pack horse it the rest of the way. But you owe me one.
Excuse me?
Well, then we're even, at least.
I'll think about it.
Just be careful.
See you up there, sweetie. Thank you.
It is so tempting to let her die. Well, let me look. And Emily's back to where she was on the relationship status. And then there's Ashley, has a crush on Chris, academic, inquisitive, forthright. I don't know where I was going with that last word.
Whoa, hello. Somebody's getting a little friendly. And not in the friend zone kind of way. They might need to check the expiration date on their big breakup.
Oh.
Oh!
Oh, God.
Hey, whoa. Sorry there. Sorry about that, Ash. I didn't mean to scare
Jeez
you.
Louise, well, Matt.
I did mean to scare you, sort of scare you, but not like for real scare
my
you.
Gosh,
I'm gonna be
oh
honest
God.
With this dude.
Hey, well, man, I'm really sorry, Ash. Damn.
Because it's I hate okay, Emily fine. That much.
What are you looking at? See anything juicy with that thing? Let me check it out.
Sure. Go ahead. Knock yourself out. Yes.
Son of a bitch. Seriously, Emily? What the hell, man?
Hey, listen, it's probably nothing.
Nothing, you think?
Well, yeah.
Is it ever just nothing with him?
No.
Ever?
I don't know.
No.
Damn it.
Matt.
All right. I was honest with him. Wow, Jess starts out not liking Sam that much. Oh my god. All right.
You did not just do that.
Put your hands where I can see them. We've got you surrounded.
But who am I to retaliate? What choice do I, a supple young rebel girl, have but to surrender to the strapping military guard come to take me into custody?
Well, I don't know when you put it like that. Hey! Oh, great. Hey, you know that?
Just gotta stop playing music.
Where are you hiding, little chicken? Oh, ah!
Oh,
Hey!
Oh, snap! Hello? Come on. Hey, Mike. Boom, shakalaka.
Okay. You got me. Fair enough. Okay.
Sometimes doing nothing is the right thing to do.
You can't hide from me, Michael. I know all your tricks.
I'm not going to hit the bird.
Did I go down?
I don't think so.
I think you'd know so if I did.
All right.
So are we calling?
Sorry,
you
I got a clear my
then?
Throat there.
You're a worthy opponent, Miss Jessica, the Snowball Queen.
Okay, that sounds vaguely dirty.
My lady.
It is.
Ah!
Oh ho ho! Okay. Okay, you're really gonna get it.
What am I gonna get?
Well, I can think of at least one thing.
Yeah?
But you'll have to wait until later. We should get up to the lodge.
Yeah. It's so nice out here, though. Pretty breathtaking.
I mean, I could stay out here for pretty much ever, provided I was making out with you the whole time.
Just making out?
Again.
Whoa.
I need to clear my throat.
Well, you might freeze to death somewhere in between those quotes.
Yeah.
Let's see here. What did I do? Curious. Didn't even know curious went down. I'm not that curious. I'm just gonna fucking hit you with a snowball. Hi.
And how are we feeling?
Dizzy today. It's a dizzy day. Not a good
day. In our last session, we established that you have a fear of things that are dead or undead.
Did we?
This time...
I said to be scared. I didn't say we have fear.
The root of your anxiety. Now pick up that book. Turn the pages. You will see a set of pictures and symbols. I want you to identify which image in each set makes you the most anxious.
Okay. Honestly, there are more jobs I trust to a woman than I do a man. I don't mind planes. I don't like crowds. That's an excellent choice. I'm not really afraid of heights. I guess I would be afraid of drowning. What you writing, Doc? Oh, God. Neither one are scary to me. But the fact that you can get shot from anywhere and not see it coming. I don't mind cockroaches. Snakes, on the other hand. Oh, God. I just want to get this page done with. Don't like clowns. The gore doesn't really... it does disgust me. In video games, not so much. In real life, I was in... I went into a room and... there was just guts and it made me gag. It was smelly. I guess I'd have to go with gore.
Oh. Did that startle you? So sorry. You're doing very well.
I'm gonna stick that pen down your fucking throat.
Try to speed up a bit. The more you rely on your instincts, the more honest your answers will be, and the more enlightening you will find this experience.
I don't like spiders in real life. I don't mind spiders on TVs or screens or anything. I just don't want them near me. Needles don't bother me. Yep, back to the clown. I'm not afraid of dogs. I'm not afraid of storms! Come on!
This is very interesting. Thank you for answering so diligently.
Yeah, you ever slap your hand on the table again, I'm gonna stick that frickin' pen in your throat.
An awful. Some combination sounds like a good Friday night. Well, I'm afraid, once again, we're out of time, but...
I think I need a new psychiatrist, therapist, whatever you are. I need a new one. I don't want to come back here. Previously on Until Dawn.
You guys think this is a little bit...
Oh, come on. She deserves it.
Hannah! What's going on? Where's my sister going?
It was just a prank, Han.
No!
First off, I gotta say, I am super excited to welcome all my pals back to the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway. I really want to spend some quality time with each and every one of you and just share some moments that we'll never forget for the sake of my sisters.
I need to go find Sam.
Son of a bitch! So I got moved to the back and next to Josh. That's how we met.
Boom. Butterfly effect.
I feel like this mountain gets bigger every time I climb it.
Oh, yeah? That feels the same to me.
Josh, Hannah and Beth's brother, complex, thoughtful, loving.
Come on, you grew up here. It probably feels like it's shrinking.
I guess that's true.
When are you gonna install some cell towers up here? I'm getting withdrawals already.
You got a spare million lying around, and I'll fix you right up.
Funny you should say that. I think I left it in my other jacket.
Oops. Hey, guys. Get up here okay?
Yeah. Well, more or less, but it is so good to see you.
What's up with him?
Yo, yo, yo. We got things moving up here or what?
Yeah, man.
Hey, you doing all right? I mean, I know it must be really tough without your sis.
Stop.
I just meant that...
No, I know what you meant. You know, seriously, I'm over it. And I want us to have a good time, you know? Like we always used to.
Damn it. It's a freaking thing.
It's iced.
What else?
Maybe there's another way in.
There are a million ways in. They're just all locked.
There's gotta be like a window around the corner we can get open or something.
Wait a second. Are you saying we should break in?
I don't think it's technically breaking in if you own the place, right?
Hey, not if I don't report you. Lead the way, coaches.
Hey, Ash.
Hi, Chris.
So, how are you doing?
Good, but a little cold. I think I could use some time curled up by the fire.
Yeah, that does sound pretty nice.
Alright, moving on. I'm having a hard time focused, so I apologize. I'm whatever's wrong with me. It's a dizzy day for me.
She's like a sleeper hit kind of gal, you know? Now I just want to rip that parka right off of her and make some snow angels, right?
No. Absolutely.
When are you gonna take her to the bone zone?
Like that could ever happen.
Come on, man. She practically spends her entire life with you as it is.
Well, yeah, but we're like friends.
Listen, dude, look around you. Look at these beautiful mountains. Do you see any parents? I mean, can you imagine a more perfect, ripe scenario just dripping with erotic possibilities? You and Ashley alone at last. You've laid all the groundwork. You've been a perfect gentleman. Now, you come in for the kill.
Yeah, let's kill her.
Maybe you're right.
Oh, wait, that's not what we're talking about.
No hunter, bro. No fear, no mercy. I mean, she won't even know what hit her.
all right, I got it. Jeez.
So, how are we planning on breaking into my parents' lodge, bud?
I didn't say I had a plan.
You sounded like you had a plan. You better deliver, Cochise, or else you got four lovely ladies who are going to be freezing their buns off. And last time I checked, that's not a good way to get laid.
Oh, shoot. Nobody likes cool buns.
Well, we got ourselves a thinker. Nice one.
Oh, I forgot to check the fire axe.
Attention in climbing class.
You mean Jim?
Yeah, you know, with the climbing up the rope.
Whoa.
Did I do that?
I don't think so. Here, use this. Whoa, Chris, I just got an awesome idea.
Yeah?
Totally.
What is it?
Okay, so I'm pretty sure that I've got some deodorant in one of the bathrooms. You could use that with the lighter.
I don't follow. How's a stick of deodorant gonna help?
Spray on. It's a can.
Oh, yeah. Now I gotcha.
Flamethrower.
Just like we did with the Lormy dudes.
Yep. Ones we melted. Just point the spray can in the lighter and whoosh.
Bye-bye, frozen lock.
Bingo. All right, so you got this. I'm gonna go sort something out. You up for hunting around in the dark for a little bit?
Usually.
Nope, but I'll do it.
Godspeed, Pilgrim.
Totem. Lost totem. Was that Emily? Can I light Emily on fire? That would make me happy. Although, with what I just said, I'm trying to keep everyone alive. There's a thing. Read the thing.
So, what have we here?
Any other things? Oh, excuse me. Ominous.
Huh. That's cool.
All right, so yeah. I've missed a lot of stuff, probably. Was nothing, never you mind.
Hi, Chris, very funny.
Oh, how'd you know it was me?
Shouldn't you be like getting the lock open or something?
On it.
All right, let's go. The whispering doesn't help much. If you've never played this game with all the audio going through your headset, I recommend it. The whispering kind of adds it to be creepier. Find something downstairs. Let them freeze their buns off a little bit longer. Oh god, there's two things down here. Oh, it's a doorknob. The cinema room. Yeah, see, I'm finding missing stuff here. That's never a good sign. Alright, let's go back up the stairs since there's nothing here. Please stop whispering in my ear. I fear what you're saying in my ear. Okay. This is the bathroom. Is there something I just lit up in here? No. Beware bad.
Get the fuck.
Or Wolverine.
Freezing our buns off out here.
Thank you. I'll be here all week.
Crap, that thing freaked me out.
What was it? Are you okay?
It was like a bear or a tiger or something.
Oh, it was just a cute little baby Wolverine.
Baby?
Don't worry, buddy. You're gonna be a big boy soon. Home sweet home.
Sweet is not the word I'd use.
Oh my gosh, it's so good to be inside. Even if it's still kind of freezing in here.
I'll get a fire going.
This place barely looks any different.
Yeah, nobody's been up here.
Even with all the police coming in and out?
Not a lot of action up here lately.
Nope.
What's up, party people?
Hi.
Hey.
Triggered.
At home, bro. Will do.
Yeah. Come on in. Take a load off. Have whatever you want. You just take whatever you want anyway, right?
Whoa. Easy there, cowboy.
Conflict.
What the hell were you doing with M out on the trail?
What?
I saw you and M. The telescope.
Before? We just ran into each other. Been a while, so we hugged and I said hello. Is that against the law?
Right. Yeah. Duh. Sorry, it's been kind of a long day. I overreacted.
Nah, man. Don't worry about it.
Cool? All right.
Yeah,
fix
yeah,
things.
Totally.
Maybe. I don't know.
Oh my god, that is so gross. Are you trying to swallow his face whole?
Em.
I mean, seriously, can she be any more obvious? No one wants in on your territory, honey.
You do.
Excuse me? Did you say something?
Oh, did you not hear me? Was your sluttiness too loud?
Sounds like someone's bitter she didn't make the cut.
Yeah, it's all a big cattle call with that dreamboat. Congrats, you're top cow.
Cuts real deep calling Miss Homecoming a cow.
You're making everyone uncomfortable, Jess.
Jealous much? Emily too frigid for you too.
Hey, that's look.
Whatever. I don't give a crap what you think.
At least I can think. 4.0, bitch. Honor roll. Suck on that when you're trying to sleep your way into a job.
Who needs grades when you've got all the natural advantages you can handle?
Oh, please.
You couldn't buy a moldy loaf of bread with your skanky ass.
Are you serious? Do you think that's insulting?
That bitch is on crack or something.
I kind of want to see where this goes.
Okay?
No. You're the one who needs to keep your nose out of other people's business.
I'm about to get right up in your business, you bitch.
Are we about to get real? Because I am down to get real.
Stop it! This is not why we came up here. This is not helping. It's not what I wanted.
Josh, you're a hero.
We can't get along for 10 minutes, and maybe we need a little bit of a break, right? Mike, why don't you check out the guest cabin, the one I told you about?
Yeah. Alright. Wanna go do that?
Any place without that whore?
Right up the trail.
Well, that's over.
Yeah.
So, Josh, should we get this fire going?
Where's my bag?
Huh?
My bag, the little bag with the pink pattern, the one I got on Rodeo. Matt, are you listening? Oh my god, don't you remember? Next to the Italian shoe place where I got the stilettos and you knocked over the rack while you were drooling all over that girl at the counter?
Well, I mean, she was asking about my letter jacket.
Right, because she gave a shit about your designer letter jacket.
Why do you hate my jacket?
Matt, I need my bag.
Oh my god, Em, maybe you just forgot it.
Do you seriously think I'd forget my bag?
Yes, I think you'd forget your bag.
Guess not.
You must have left it down by the cable car station. Come on, hon. We'll be back soon.
Then we can get warm.
We can get very warm.
Okay. Okay, let's go.
Okay, I'm gonna go take a bath.
You do that.
Exiled.
Oh, hey there. Sorry, I didn't see you. Message.
Worked for me.
Oh, brr.
TPS Eternity.
How far is this cabin anyway?
Hello.
This cabin is the
I don't
coziest,
know you sent that. I'm
most
sorry.
Romantic love den you will ever lay your eyes upon.
If we ever make it.
I have a feeling luck's on our side.
Play your cards right and maybe you will get lucky.
Hey, porn stars. Gonna need these.
Porn star?
I'd pay to see it.
Gross.
Hey, I'm sorry to kick you out like that.
No worries, man.
Oh, I'm sure you'll find a way to entertain yourselves.
Mm-hmm. You have fun with the peanut gallery.
Oh, I almost forgot. Gotta fire up the generator so you can see where you're going. It's dark out there.
All right. Roger that.
I think Josh was flirting with me.
Okay. You want to invite him up with us?
Wait, really?
What? No.
All right, let's see here. Let's see what shit we've caused. Wow, yeah. He just hates Matt. What's over here? Just out of curiosity. Is this where we...
Burr, it is freezing out here.
Now that's something I can help you with.
And how are you gonna do that?
I got a few things in mind.
Wait, was there something up here? I feel like I'm missing stuff. Yeah, there's nothing here. Totem. Danger totem. Hi! Can I see you? In the window? No, I can't see you in the window.
Zam!
Good, right?
Yeah, totally. No, this is awesome.
Oh, yeah. I bring the hits.
Did you people quit playing copyrighted music? God damn it.
You psyched yet? You don't look psyched yet.
I am so psyched right now.
It's like a little adventure. A sexcapade.
Wow.
Clean it up.
Well, they never closed the investigation.
Okay, I'm getting the creeps now.
Well, wherever they are, I'm sure they're happy. We're all thinking about them.
That's a nice way of thinking about it.
Thank you for stopping the music. Where are you going?
Did you hear that?
That's a cause for concern, people.
Something. Yeah. Damn. I don't think we can get up to the cabin with a path block like this.
Oh, no way am I going back to the lodge, aka Wax Museum, to drink hot chocolate.
Jess! Fuck! Hey, Jessica!
Yep. Hey. Okay.
Holy crap, you scared the heck out of me.
How do you think I felt?
You didn't hit your head or anything.
As far as I can tell, I still have all 7 of my limbs.
yeah. Can you get out?
I don't know. I can hardly see anything down here.
Be heroic.
Right, I'm coming after you. Just stay put.
There's a dude there.
Hey, handsome. Wanna help me move this cart thing?
Help me move it. I imagined us grunting together. This is not what I pictured.
Yes, got it. Sex jokes.
Giving me the willies, and not the good kind of willies.
Can I offer you a little comfort and reassurance?
We'll save it for the cabin buster.
Let's see here, because I think I'm supposed to go up the stairs. Let's go over here. Nope, yep, another totem. That's a hint later in the game. I don't think we'll see any trophies pop up on the screen. I did just remember I forgot to turn that off again. But, I think if we're gonna see a trophy, it'll be way late in the game.
Huh. Stogie.
Weird place to hang out and smoke cigars.
It's recent. Wonder who's out there.
Whoa.
Okay, I'm finding all the stuff and not actually looking. Yeah, see the axe is right there.
This is like historical.
Holy Batcave.
It's gotta be Native American, right?
I don't think the miners were getting their arts and crafts on, no.
No, it's like a shrine or something.
A shrine to what?
Ithacar.
You alright?
Yeah. Close one.
shrine to Ithakar. You did not worship. Ithakar crush you with beam.
Jesus. This place is a real fixer-upper.
Give your faith unto Ithakar or die. Okay, I'm done with the Ithakar jokes.
Finally, a little ray of hope.
Crunch, 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 crunch. What we got over here? Nothing.
Well, well. When Josh said cabin, I thought like Abe Lincoln.
Where do you see the Lincoln bedroom?
Oh, are you planning on getting presidential on me?
Take a ride on Air Force One.
All right. Save it for the stump. Ooh, a telescope. Gonna look at the trees. Gonna look at the clouds. Gonna look at the cabin. Whoa.
You all right?
I just saw someone at the cabin.
Okay. Let me see.
I saw nobody.
Hey, Jess?
Mm-hmm?
Stay close by, okay?
What's up?
This posting says there's some brown bears up here sometimes.
Oh, Michael, I have the best idea.
What?
Let's go hug a bear. Come on, please. Come on.
Let's not hug a bear.
I love the snow. But as walking as far as they have, my happy ass would have slipped a good 3-4 times. I was nice to nature, you beast.
Just answering is mating call.
Wow, you're easy.
Yeah. Got a lot of love to give. I'm scared.
Well, I'll talk about easy. Talk to the person in front of you.
Sending us up here?
Really?
What?
I didn't figure you for the glass half empty type.
You got a better idea?
Stand back, Debbie Downer.
Oh, boo! Show off.
Hey, Mike. You've got something on your face. Ah! Boo!
Okay. Well, that's how it's gonna be. Jess? Sammy!
What?
You wanna help me get this fire going?
Well, I was just getting into the bath.
Oh, do you need any help with that?
Hardy har. right, Josh, let's see if you know how to hook up the hot water in your big fancy lodge.
Tell ya, but you wouldn't hear me anyway. Finding all kinds of stuff about twins. Keep searching. Something here. Here? Nope.
Okay, well, I'm pretty sure that somewhere in this crazy place we used to have a spirit board.
A what?
Wow, you have a spirit board?
yeah, they're fun, right?
Those things are a joke, man. They don't do shit.
No way, bro. I mean, we used to do it all the time. Me and... Well,
Josh, no hot water's kind of a major oversight, don't you think?
Yeah, you just gotta fire up the boiler. It's in the basement. All right, you guys, see if you can find the spirit board.
Chris, let's go find it. It'll be like a scavenger hunt.
Okay. Guess so.
Brad, I mean, you're not gonna regret it. You up for a ride along?
Thank you.
this how I gave Chris and Ash a mission together? Yeah, I was thinking they could use some alone time.
They are very sweet together. I wish they'd just freaking get on with it already.
I swear, they just need, like, something to bond over, you know, some sort of traumatic event to send them into each other's arms. I mean, at this rate, they'll be in the geriatric ward before Chris makes a move. You know, Sam.
Yes, Josh.
I just wanted to say.
What?
It really means a lot to me that everyone came back this year, and you know, that you came, Sam.
Josh, we're here for you. Really, whatever you need, whenever, we're all gonna make it through this. Together.
I hope so.
I want us to have a good time, you know? Hey, watch your step.
I think I can handle a little old set of stairs.
Mm-hmm.
Let's explore the basement before I go too far.
Sorry to drag you down into the bowels.
Oh, just get me some hot water and I'll be super fine.
I mean, I wouldn't want you coming down here on your own, you know?
Well, it's definitely creepy down here.
Yep. Not a place to be on your own.
Rough playing baseball out in all that snow.
No, it wasn't in the winter, silly. I mean, we'd come up in the summer and we would have the best time. The whole family was there. Mom, Dad, my sisters. It was some serious competition out there on the big lawn. I don't know. Can't go back. New reality, right, Sam? Anyway, I'm supposed to be fixing this old guy, right? Here, can you hold this?
What was that?
What was what? Just shine it here so I can see what I'm doing.
Not moving.
Nice one.
I was moving a little.
Okay, first things first. We gotta increase the water pressure before we get the boiler fired up.
Sounds kinda complicated.
No, it's actually pretty simple. It's okay. I'm just try again.
There we go. Someone went going by.
All right. Five, girl. Yeah.
I even heard them.
Don't be an a-hole, okay? I totally didn't jump. All I said was, what was that? Which is a totally normal reaction to hearing a super creepy noise in a super creepy basement. Wait, okay, so you hear that too, right? Josh.
What?
The rhythm's like weirdly regular.
Nothing regular about it.
I'm gonna go check it out.
What? Why?
What do you care, Franny Face?
No, it's probably just, like, not anything.
Why don't you hold down the fort while I make sure?
Whatever you say, madam.
Was I not supposed to take advantage of the opportunity?
Are you serious? Were you in on this, Putz?
No, but I wish I was. That was too good.
I'm ready to admit that your dumb little prank may have a slight whiff of humor.
Joke master.
Well, I said nothing about jokes. I said your prank, which was dumb.
Holy crap, you were scared, admit it.
I was not!
Come on, you totally pissed yourself.
Josh!
What in God's name are you wearing?
I found my true calling.
Mm-hmm. Please tell me you're gonna take a vow of silence. Okay, did you at least find the thingy?
Oing. Here's our one-way ticket to the spirit realm.
You know what? No. I've just been through enough spooking for one night, okay? I see a hot bath in my crystal ball. All right? So have fun. Oh, but watch out for that Josh. He's a schemer.
Okay.
Righto. Oh, hey, your room is, a lot creepier, and there's a beating heart on your desk.
To understand your feelings toward people of fear, the supernatural, ghosts, spirits, and other intangible forces beyond the veil. Do you share this fear?
Do I share this fear? No.
And how do you feel about people who are afraid?
Well, not okay with the giant spider.
Isolation. Do you feel pity for him? Indeed, that is apparent from the choices you made. Investigate your feelings toward other people in greater depth. What you value, what you respect in yourself and others. Which would you say was most important in a person, loyalty or honesty?
Nobody wants to hear the truth, but everyone wants a loyal friend.
So you would tell a lie in order to be loyal to a friend, okay. And what about loyalty versus charity?
I'll stick with loyalty.
So you would sooner look after your friends before caring for those in greater need?
Well, I'm currently one in greater need at the moment,
well,
so...
Again, I'm afraid we're out of time. We'll talk again soon.
Will we? Well, I'm going to go ahead and leave this here. Thanks, y'all, for watching. Remember to like and subscribe. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Twitch. Go everywhere. Follow me there. It's all under the same name. And I will catch you all in the next one. Later.